All right. Welcome back, guys, to our channel. I'm Rod. I'm here with my dad.
Rod Sr.
And we are Bridging the Gap. Yes, sir. The boys is back with another reaction video for your head top. And thank you so much for watching our videos. If this is your first time here, thank you. If you're returning, thank you as well. Please put a big old thumbs up on this video and drop a comment and let us know what we should listen to next. As well as turn on your notification bells to make sure that you are notified every time that we drop a new video. Now that all that's out of the way, oh man, I'm going to reveal to my dad what album we're going to do today. I haven't told him yet. Today, Dad, we're going to be listening to The Eminem Show.
The Eminem Show.
Yeah, The Eminem Show. So we're going
to. You know I like Eminem.
I know you like Eminem. And so this is probably one of our highest requested albums at this point in time.
Really?
Yep. And people have been annoying me about this album ever since I called it corny on one of our other videos.
That was the one that we're talking about.
Yep. Okay, and then I called it corny on another video recently, and now they've the new people are,
you're in trouble.
Yeah, I'm in trouble. But I don't know. I mean, I do like some songs on here, or I like songs on here. Whatever. I don't want to say too much of my personal opinion. I want you to just listen to it.
I wonder whether I'm going to agree with the majority on this as opposed to
what I think. Yeah, maybe. Yeah. But so that's why we're going to do it. We're going to listen to it. This is the album that Eminem dropped after the Marshall Mathers LP, which is what the first album that we listened to from Eminem.
Right.
This was released May 26, 2002. It's his fourth studio album. It was released on Aftermath and Shady Records and Interscope Records. The album saw Eminem take a substantially more predominant production role. So most of it is produced by Eminem.
Okay.
With his longtime collaborators, Jeff Bass and Dr. Dre, being the album's executive producer.
Okay.
So there's some features from D12, Eminem's group, Dr. Dre, Nate Dogg. We're going to hear from Obie Trice on here as well, as well as Eminem's daughter, Haley Jade.
Okay.
Yeah, the album was super, 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 super successful. Pretty much how all Eminem albums are.
What's the daughter's name again?
Haley Jade.
Haley Jade.
So it was. It went 12 times platinum. It's sold 27 million copies. It's one of the best-selling albums of all time.
Okay, so then, you know what? I haven't even heard this album yet, but if it's done all of that and you got it corny, I don't know, man. You might be off a little bit on that one.
I don't know. Well, here's the thing, though. So Eminem has a very specific fan base, and they love Eminem,
of course,
all over the world. And I respect Eminem and how talented he is as a rapper, but it's just not what I get in my car, and ride around to.
Okay.
Marshall Mathers LP.
I like the way you phrased it.
Yeah. Because they're there. They're going to.
I know. It's cool, though. It's cool.
Oh, yeah. We love the stands. The stands. That's the Eminem fans. They're the stands.
The stands.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. So, yeah, I won't hold you guys too long. We'll get right into it. The first track on the Eminem Show is a skit. It's called Curtains Up. And this one is produced by Eminem, and then it rolls right into the first track, which is titled White America. And White America is also produced by Eminem, I'm assuming.
All right, so we get right. It's the Eminem Show.
It's the Eminem Show.
All right.
Yeah, y'all. Hey, and after this video, I don't want to hear. We not listening no more Eminem. Okay, nah, we will. I don't know, probably, but I don't want to hear no more of that. I did it. Here we go. All right. Curtains up, and then White America. Here we go.
Rights and the stars for the rights that men have died for to protect. talk shit on my life, and now I'm jumping in on white America. I could be one of your kids. White America. Little Eric looks just like this. White America. Little Eric looks just like this. White America. Erica loves my shit. I go to TRL. Look how many hugs I get. Look at these eyes, baby blue, baby, just oh, like yourself. Damn. If they were brown, yeah. Shady Lou, Shady.
That's the Eminem production.
But Shady's cute, Shady new, Shady's dimples would help. Give me the mic, show me where the fucking studio's at. When I was underground, no one gave a fuck, I was white. No labels wanted
that's
to
beat,
sign
me,
almost
man.
Gave up, yeah. I was like, fuck into these guys.
That's
like,
a yeah, nasty beat, man.
I'm like, my skin is just starting to work to my benefit now. It's white,
yeah.
America. I could be one of your kids. Erica loves my shit. I go to TRL, look
he's smoking
I
this, dude.
Yeah.
I could be one of your kids. See, the problem is I speak to suburban kids who otherwise would have never knew these words yep. Exist. Whose moms probably would have never gave two squirts of piss till I created so much motherfucking turbulence. Swing out the tube right into your living rooms, I came. And kids flipped when they knew I was produced by Dre. That's all it took, and they were instantly hooked right
this
in. And
tight.
They connected me too because I look like them. That's me while I write.
You wasn't feeling
like
that.
I like this song.
Yeah.
I
like that.
Just look at me like I'm your closest pal. The poster child. Fuck you with the divided state of embarrassment will allow me to have.
This is hard, dude.
Oh, man. All right.
I'm just playing, America. You know I love you.
All right. That was track number two, White America.
Eminem be tripping.
What do you think about that one?
I'm just playing, America.
So what'd you think about just that song as a whole?
Man, I was feeling all of that song.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was that man, the beat and man, he kind of reminds me when you know he in his raps, this deep message like Tupac when he does his when he does his thing.
Mm-hmm.
It kind of, you know, he's like he speaks of what's going on today
mm-hmm.
and he's so on point with it. And man, and then he just incorporates that with his talent, rapping. And man, and that beat, it was hard, dude.
That was a hard beat.
It was like, I was like, boom.
Yeah.
It just made more. But I don't know. I don't know why you don't like this album. Well, okay, put it like this. I can't say that yet because I haven't heard the rest of it.
Yeah.
So there might be some something there. My man be like, oh, I feel you, bro.
So, I guess this is kind of his content is, especially on this song, is kind of like a continuation of him just fighting the battle against like the government and the people that are trying to silence him and censor him and all that mm-hmm. stuff like that. We saw those themes in the last album.
Right.
So I'm all about that. And he's kind of like, you know, poking fun at white America, like, you know, these are the I look just like y'all. That's the reason I'm so popular, but y'all hate me.
Right, and, right.
But, you know,
and that's why I like man. And that the message he was like, he's just telling it like it really is.
Mm.
You know,
yeah.
You know, but people need to open up their eyes. That's what he's telling them. Open up your eyes. This is how it is. And then he just points out certain things that he has issues with.
Yeah,
yeah, man. That was a nice song.
Yeah, no, he killed White America for sure. That was a really big song off of this album.
Yeah.
Pretty big single. And I really like the acknowledgement that he makes saying, you know, like, if I was black, then I would have sold half.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
You know, a lot of there's like this term culture vulture
mm-hmm.
of like,
of course,
you know, white people coming into a black culture and eating off of it and not like acknowledging the people or whatever, you know.
Right.
So I think he's always been a person that acknowledges his privilege and acknowledges like the fact that, you know, his skin color is part of what makes him like, you know, so appealing and
right.
all that
I mean,
stuff.
He just, like I said, he just tells it like it is.
Yeah, for
you
sure.
Just open your eyes and look at it. He's right there. He's fully exposed. He's telling everybody who he is.
Mm-hmm.
And he's going to tell you what's on his mind.
That's a fact. And yeah, I think that's one of the big reasons why Eminem is so popular, because he doesn't hold back. He says what's on his mind no matter who you are, if you like it or not.
Right.
You're going to get these words. You're going to get these bars.
I like that. He's bold.
Yeah.
I like boldness.
I like that. All right, cool. We'll go ahead and roll into track number three. This one is titled Business. This is produced by Dr. Dre. And I'm trying to get my phone on silent. Let's try. There we go. All right. This is titled The Business, produced by Dr. Dre. Here we go.
Marshall. Sounds like an SOS.
Holy whack, unlyrical lyrics, Andre. You're fucking right.
To the rap mobile. Let's go.
To the rap mobile.
Usha.
Uh-oh.
Usha. Bitches and gentlemen, it's showtime.
Boy.
Hurry, step right up. Introducing the star of our show. His name is Usha.
You know you like it.
So without further ado, I bring to you Usha.
You about to witness hip hop in its most purest, most rawest form, flow, almost flawless.
Yeah.
Most hardest, most honest, known artist. Chip off the your blood. Oh, God, looks like that. And doors off the hinges. Yeah, here I come, I'm inches away from you, dear. Fear none. Hip hop is in a state of nine.
Oh. What? I think I'm teaching you how to listen to this album
right
now.
I guess so, baby.
You be bouncing in the car when you had it.
You be like,
you ain't even impressed.
Like a female with good looks who cooks and cleans. So much more. People, when you're rapping, you know what for. The show must go on. So I'm gonna play around.
Yeah.
Listen
that.
The Business, produced by Dr. Dre, track number four on the album. What do you think about that one, Dad?
Yeah, you could tell it was a Dr. Dre influence, definitely. But it had that, man, that song rocked.
Yeah.
Yeah, all the way through.
Mm-hmm.
All the way through. The rapping was tight. The music was tight. The production was just excellent. I liked all the vocals that came in on, you know, in you know, throughout the song.
Mm-hmm.
Man. Them first two.
Yeah.
I don't know, bro. This one so far.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Feeling it so far?
Yeah.
All right, cool.
I hope he keeps it coming though.
Yep. Well, go ahead.
Yeah, I'm just saying, I just hope he keeps it coming. If he keeps it coming through this whole album, he's a true G.
Oh yeah. Well, like I said, this is one of his highest performing albums, and highest selling albums. So it was right off of Marshall Mathers LP, which was to me my favorite Eminem project.
Okay.
So he was kind of still in that bag. This definitely has a bunch of dope records on here. Just wasn't. Anyway. All right, the next song, I really like this song. It's probably one of the biggest singles off of this album.
Oh, really?
This is called Cleaning Out My Closet, produced by Jeff Bass and Eminem. Uh-huh. And this one, yeah, it's a really big song. It's kind of him continuing on the backstory. You know, he beefs with a couple people. America, one of them. Another one being his baby mom Kim, and then also his mother. And
his mother.
Yeah. You know he beefs with his mom.
That's right. It was. You're right.
Yeah, he beefs with his mom quite a bit. But this is him kind of continuing and giving more context as to why he beefs with his mom.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah. Okay. All right. So here we go. Cleaning out my closet.
Cleaning out my closet. It makes sense.
Have you ever been hated or discriminated against? I have. I've been protested and demonstrated against. Picket signs for my wicked rhymes. Look at the times. Sick is the mind of the motherfucking kid that's behind. All this come up. See, they can trigger me, but they'll never figure me out. Look at me now. I bet you're probably sick of me now. Ain't you, mama? I'ma make you look so ridiculous now. I'm sorry, mama. I never meant to hurt you. I got some skeletons in my closet, and I don't know if no one knows it. So before they throw me inside my coffin and close it, I'ma expose it. I'll take you back to 73, before I ever had a multi-platinum selling CD. I was a baby, maybe I was just a couple of months. Thanks, but I'm only human, but I'm man enough to face him today. What I did was stupid, no doubt it was dumb. But the smartest shit I did was take the bullets out of that gun. Cause I'd have killed him. Shit, I would have shot Kim and them both. It's my life. I'd like to welcome y'all to the Eminem show. Whoa. I'm sorry, mama. I never meant to hurt you. So you could try to justify the way you treated me. Guess what, you're getting older now. When it's cold, when you're lonely. And Nathan's growing up so quick, he's gonna know that you're phony. And Haley's getting so big now. Get you selfish bitch, I hope you fucking burn in hell for this shit. Remember when Ronnie died and you said you wished it was me? Well guess what, I am dead. Dead to you as can be. I'm sorry, mama.
Ooh.
I never meant to hurt deep. You.
Yeah, it is.
Like that, like a Spanish flair, the guitar and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So this one here, it was so deep, man. It's like stuff he had to get off his mind.
Mm-hmm.
And you know what? I think now I realize why people really love this album.
Mm-hmm.
Because, I mean, he's speaking things that, he connected with everybody because everybody's got closets to clean.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And some people, man, I imagine when this album came out, it was hitting home for a lot of people.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
For sure.
But I like this song, man. He's so deep.
Yeah.
And his rap just flows.
Yeah, he's got a killer flow, and I think, yeah, just the deepness of this song. He's talking about so many personal things in such a personal way and just sharing it with everybody. It's just,
and, you know, that's what I noticed about him, man. He's, you know, a lot of his rap songs are personal stuff. He's telling people, you know. So
yeah, it's like a different level of vulnerability than any other rappers, I guess, at this time. Mm-hmm. Especially on his level,
right?
To share like these personal feuds with, like, you know, his dad and his mom, and just, you know, I guess saying that, you know, his little brother's getting older, and I'm gonna, you know, make sure that he knows how much you're a fraud, and I don't know. it's a really deep thing for sure.
It's deep. Some of it's sad.
Yeah.
You know, but, you know, he's just expressing himself the way he feels.
Yeah, at the time, yeah.
Yeah. Haley, that's...
his daughter.
His daughter.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and he was like, whatever happens in life, He seems like he's going to focus on that.
Yeah, always make sure she's good.
Yeah.
For sure. Cool. So we'll go ahead and roll into the next track, which is track number 5, Square Dance.
Square Dance. Oh, Square Dance.
Square Dance. This one is produced by Eminem and Jeff Bass as well.
Jeff Bass.
Yeah.
Have we seen him on there?
Jeff Bass frequently collaborates with Eminem's production. So, yeah.
Well, we never seen him anywhere else, though, on any of the other rappers.
No. Just on Eminem's albums. Okay. Yeah. But he did produce on the last album as well as this one.
Okay.
All right. Here we go. Square Dance.
Never been the type to bend a barge, the wrong button to push, no friend to push. I'm a centerpiece, you're a Maltese, I'm a pit bull off his leash. All this peace talk can cease.
Like
all
it.
These people I had to leave in limbo. I'm back now, I've come to release this info. I'll be brief and let me just keep shit simple. Can a bitch don't want no beef with Slim? No, not even on my radar. So won't you please jump off my dick, lay off and stay off. And follow me to the track, yeah, kick on back. Boom. The boogie monster of rap, yeah, the man's back with a plan to ambush this Bush administration. Mush the Senate's facing, push this generation of kids to stand and fight for the right to say something you might not like. Fucking assassins hijacking Amtrak's crashing. All this terror, America demands action. Next thing you know, you got Uncle Sam's ass asking to join the army. Yep. Or what you do yep. for the Navy? You just a baby getting recruited at 18. You're on a plane now eating their food and they baked beans. I'm 28, they gon' take you for they take me. Crazy insane or insane crazy. When I say Hussein, you say shady. Money, I have the money to have you killed by somebody who has nothing. I'm past bluffing, past the KY. Let's get ready for some intense serious
cold, man.
That's Square Dance, track number 5 off of The Eminem Show. What'd you think about that one, Dad?
Man, the production on that, the music was tight, boy. And then, man, I love to hear him rap.
Yeah.
Yeah, I love the content.
Mm-hmm.
Man, dude, okay, how many is that? The three songs we heard are 4?
Four.
It's 4, that's okay, that's the 4th one?
Mm-hmm. Shh. 4 for 4 for you?
4 for 4 for show.
Okay, this is one of the ones that I used to like skip pretty
used to skip it
pretty frequently. I just never liked the hook. I won't just fur dance me. I just couldn't do it.
Do that again.
Won't just fur dance me. I just never really he kills the verses though. Like and that's the thing, like you can't like, I mean, he's rapping, and he's talking about stuff. Like, this is a diss track. He's a there was this other rapper, Cannabis, who actually beefed with LL Cool J back in the day, and he dissed Eminem on a track, and this is kind of Eminem, like, coming at him. He called him Cannabitch and all kind of stuff in here.
For real?
Yeah, and then he's, he's...
Oh, they bugging, man. they calling names like that? They bugging.
And he's also, just referencing some of the stuff that's going on in the world, George Bush and the Twin Towers and all that stuff, and he's kind of like anti-war and anti-blah, blah, blah, so he's kind of coming at that stuff, and yeah, I mean, he's killing these verses, but yeah, I just always used to, I skipped this one.
What you didn't like about it? Well,
I just always felt like the hook was corny, and the beat's cool. It's an Eminem beat. Eminem Beats sound like Eminem Beats.
All right. I think you better let that one go.
They're going to kill me, man, but that's just my opinion. Right.
We're going to let that go when we listen to the song. Okay.
We'll keep it going. All right. So the next track is track number 6, which is it's a skit. And then it goes into track number 7, which is titled Soldier. So yeah, here we go. The Kiss.
All right. The Kiss.
I'm gonna kill this bitch. I'm gonna kill her. I'm going to fucking jail because I'm gonna kill this bitch. Yeah, what?
I don't know. I got a really, really bad feeling.
Man, would you shut the fuck up, Gary? You always got a bad feeling, girl.
That's a car. Usually the same one.
Yeah.
It's a park.
She gets him riled up, man.
For sure. All right. We wait.
We wait for what?
We wait until she comes out, man. I'm gonna fucking kill her.
Man, you ain't gonna kill me.
Man,
what
the
fuck
did
you bring
that
for?
Just shut up. Fucking clip is in.
Man, don't point that shit at me.
It's not even loaded.
Never was a gangster till I graduated to one and got the rap of a villain. The weapon concealing. Took the image of a thug, captured a villain. Willing to stick out my neck for respect if it meant life or death.
Damn.
I never lived to regret what I said.
That flows, dude.
People just wanna you're see crazy. If it's true, if it's you. What you say in your rap, what you do, so they feel. It's part of your obligation to fulfill when they see you on the street.
Yeah.
Face to face that you're for real. The confrontation ain't no conversation if you feel you're in violation. Any hesitation to get you killed. If you feel it, kill it. You can seal it, reveal it.
Whoa.
Being reasonable will leave you full of bullets.
Special effects. I like that.
Tempt me, push me, pussies. I need a good reason to give this trigger a good squeeze.
I'm a soldier. These soldiers hold up so much, they won't budge. I'll never fall or fall.
Who needs bullets? As soon as I pull it, you sweat bullets. An excellent method to get rid of the next bullet. Actually better, cause instead of you murdering, you can hurt him and come back. Again, he kicked dirt in a Mr. Corn. Sold the room, sold the zoo. You can smell the loss as soon as I walk in the room. Everybody halts and stops and calls the cops. All you see is bitches coming out the hall to top. Running and ducking out the hot rocks. Parking lot, you'll all get shot. Whether it's your fault or not.
Oh, man. Come on, Rod.
Dude.
That boy can rap, man.
That's a fact.
Your life, try to knock the truest. I spit the illest shit ever been tried to do it. So tick-tock, listen to the sound, ticks on the clock. Listen to the sound of Kim and she licks on a cock. Listen to the sound of me spilling my heart through this pen. Motherfuckers know that I'll never be marshaled again. Full of controversy until I retire my jersey. Till the fire inside dies and expires at 30. And Lord have mercy on any more of these rappers adverse me. And put a curse on authorities in the face of adversity. I'm a soldier.
Look how he's taking it out. He's a soldier. Yeah. They marching now. They marching. Yeah.
All right. Boy. That's track number 7, Soldier, from the Eminem Show.
Man, I tell you.
Yeah.
I don't know what you had with this song.
You like that one?
Man, yeah, that was a good song. You know I like that.
Yeah.
I didn't see anything wrong with it. I don't know what the... what beef you had with it, but it's okay.
No. I was talking about Square Dance, the last one.
Oh, okay. This song, so you didn't have beef with them.
Yeah, this song's cool.
Did you like it as much as you think I liked it, though?
No. but that song's cool. And I think this is one of the songs Eminem has always said, like, how much of a influence Tupac had on him. And I think this is one of those songs that he really, like, you can hear it, like, in his flow and stuff.
Right.
A very, very Pac-ish flow.
Dude, he just bared down on it and just kept just going, digging. Like, man, he was like, he was a beast in those lines, man.
Yeah. He killed those verses for sure.
Yeah, I liked it, man.
I will never say that Eminem can't rap. He raps.
No, I know
really
you,
good.
And you've never said that.
Yeah.
I know you've never said that because when you introduced him in the beginning, I remember you was talking. You gave him much respect
for sure.
So,
but
you just had your preferences, just like I have my preferences.
Exactly,
and everybody has their preferences.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah,
just feeling that one.
I felt every song so far, and we're on number
7. That was 7.
So, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I like that. I'm giving this a new listen to now, that we're listening to it together and stuff. So I was really feeling that one, especially the verses on there. You know, he's talking about his, you know, the gun bars. I love gun bars. Anytime like rappers like talk about guns and stuff, it's always pretty cool. Yeah. So yeah, that was dope. I like that.
All right,
we'll move on to track number 8. This is called "Say Goodbye, Hollywood," and this one is produced by Eminem.
Okay.
And yeah, Eminem, "Say Goodbye, Hollywood."
All right,
here we go.
This is all Eminem. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Tough enough to stick it out with Kim, but I wasn't tough enough to juggle two things at once. Not a lot of good, I beat my daughter laying in the bottom of the mud. Must be in my blood, cause I don't know how I do it. All I know is I don't wanna follow in the footsteps of my dad, cause I hate him so bad. The first fear that I had was growing up to be like his fucking ass. Man, if you could understand why I am the way that I am, what do I say to my fans when I tell them I'm good at that? It's like a boy in the bubble who never could adapt. I'm trapped, if I could get back, I never would've. I sold my soul to the devil, I'll never get it back. I just wanna leave this game with level head intact. Imagine going from being and knowing to seeing everything blow up, and all you did was just grow up and seeing. It's fucking crazy. Cause all I wanted was to give hate to the life I never had. Instead, I forced us to live alienated.
Wow.
Yeah, the last verse is crazy.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
Say goodbye to Hollywood. There you go. I like that.
You hear that harmonica?
Yeah, yeah, that's tight.
All right, that is "Say Goodbye, Hollywood."
Like some Lee Oscar in the back, man, with that harmonica.
Lee Oscar, huh?
What do you think about Lee Oscar?
No,
that harmonica. Oh,
no.
All right.
That is track number 8, "Say Goodbye, Hollywood." What did you think about that one, Dad?
Nice song. Mm-hmm. Really nice song. Really nice flow. And I just like to settle in when he's on a song. It's just like you just want to settle in and kind of you still trying to enjoy the music, but you don't know where your attention should be drawn because the music is real good. Mm-hmm. But then you don't want to miss what he's saying.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? So it's just like a struggle. You going back to the music, then you going back to the rap to listen to it, and then you try to combine it together. It's like, damn, this dude is so good, man. You don't know which way how to listen to it. So this one is like, I would listen to this one probably a whole bunch of times, like so many of the everything on this album so far.
Yeah.
I listened to it a bunch of times, man. Yeah. It's a good, that was a good song. I liked it. What'd you think about it?
Yeah, that one, another one I used to skip.
you used to skip that one,
yeah,
too?
Yeah, I didn't like the hook. Say goodbye to Hollywood. But, okay, I won't do that. But
you know that bass line and everything was in there, man.
Yeah.
Boom, boom,
just
boom.
Like the Eminem boom, type
boom,
beat.
Boom.
Is
man.
Like, Anyway, so I'll say this.
So
that listening to it now,
for you, right?
Listening to it right now, I'm piecing together that tracks 6, 7, and 8 were all kind of like telling the story about how he ran up on the bouncer that was hooking up with his baby moms. And on "Cleaning Out My Closet," he says, "The smartest thing I did was take the bullets out of the gun,
because
I would have killed her. I would have shot Kim and him both." And now, like, I'm piecing all of that together with the, you know, the Kiss skit, and then Soldier, he's talking about the guns and how he wants to shoot the dude, and blah, 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 blah. And then this is kind of like the aftermath of him getting in that fight, and it was a whole bunch of stuff in the news and
right.
Excuse me. And all of that stuff. So I think that's really dope, like how you like
so
actually, pieced all that story
what
together.
What you're saying is you following this a little bit better than
yeah,
before.
Yeah, yeah, for sure.
So now it's kind of like when the songs come at you, they make sense.
Yeah, it's making more sense to me as I'm like sitting here reading the lyrics and kind of piecing it together and stuff.
Cool.
But yeah, I definitely used to skip this.
So
joint.
Did you like it though? Now, did you like that last one?
I think that his third verse is super fire. Like he killed that third verse. But
okay,
it's all right.
All right, just leave it alone. you still aren't completely sold. That's fine.
Yeah. Again,
I thought it was dope.
Yeah, you know? Yeah. It's dope, but it's just like not my like I don't know.
Also, what we got next?
Yeah. So track number nine is called Drips.
You gonna get ripped?
They're going to destroy me. Oh my god! And you know,
I tried to cut it. I tried to change the subject.
It's cool, man. Destroy me all you want. I don't like this album. I don't care.
I am so feeling this.
Yeah,
album.
Yeah, yeah. I'm glad. I'm glad you like it. They're gonna be glad you like it. All right. The next track is called Drips. It's track number nine, featuring Obi Trice. Obi Trice is dope. He was a frequent collaborator with Eminem. Obi Trice. This one's produced by Jeff Bass and Eminem. Collabed on this production. So yeah, here we go. Drips, Obi track number Trice. Nine, featuring Obi Trice. Here we go.
All right.
Obi. Yo,
I'm sick.
Damn. Straight dog.
Let's go.
Go there like that.
See residue was on my penis. Denise from the cleaners. Fuck me good. You should have seen us. Big booty bitch. Switch unbearable. French roll styling. Body like a stallion. Sizing up
got a bad beat too.
Getting bigger. Debating on a fucker. Do I want to be a nigga? Caressing this bitch. Plus I'm checking out the tits. Pubic hairs looking like some sour cream dip. Without the nacho. My dick hit the spot though. Pussy tighter than conditions of us black folks. In the final stretch, the last part of sex, I bust a fat ass nut. Then I woke up next, like, what the fuck is going on here? This bitch evaporated. Pussy and all just picked up and vacated. Now I'm frustrated.
I be covering your ears on this.
Dr. Wesley, I really got that shine.
Eminem sick, man.
Now I don't wanna hit no woman, but this chick's got it coming. Someone better get this bitch before she gets kicked in the stomach. And she's pregnant and she's egging me on, begging me to throw her off the steps of this porch. My only weapon is force, and I don't wanna resort to violence of any sort. But what she shoving me for? Doesn't she love me no more? Wasn't she hugging me for? Nelson sucking his dick and kissing you on the lips when you got out of Michigan. Not a plot of sticking the worst, cause you feel like you've been sticking your fucking dick in a hearse. So you paranoid at every little cold that you get. Ever since they told you this shit, you've been holding your dick. So you go to the clinic sweating every minute you win. Then the doctor comes out looking like Dennis the Menace. And it's obvious that everyone in the lobby it's AIDS. He ain't even gotta call you in his office to say it. So you check back home, cause you gon' get that hoe. When you see it, you gon' bend the fucking neck back. Cheetah.
That's why I ain't got no time
for
these games and tricks. These bitches on
my dick. That's how dudes be getting sick. Man, I don't even know what to think about it.
All right, that was Drips, track number nine off of the Eminem Show. What'd you think about that one?
Drip, yeah. Drips what?
It was called Drips.
Just Drips?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, what'd you think about that one?
Really? Well, okay.
Man, it was a good song. The beat, I liked it. Mm. You know, and, it, and like I said, I mentioned just a minute ago, it kind of, I don't know, for some reason, it kind of reminded me of Mary J. Blige.
Mm-hmm.
It's a song she has. It's got that. It's a little, hers is a little bit faster beat, but he slowed it down.
Okay.
But anyway, the song, man, True Life, man, you know. Y'all know.
Yeah.
So he just brought it out there, just put it out there and said, this is how he felt about it.
Yeah.
He wanted to talk about it. So he did.
Yep. Yeah. So the song is about how Obie Trice and Eminem both had relationships with the same girl and she gave them both STDs. So it's shit happens. And
well,
I guess I'm reading here on Genius that the song was so explicit that it was removed from the album's clean version. They didn't make it removed from the clean version. Yeah, they couldn't edit this. They couldn't edit this one.
No, I mean, unless you were just going to hear the music.
Right. It'd just be an instrumental for sure. Okay, we're going to take a quick break here.
I wonder why. That was funny, man.
Okay, we're back. So we've got our next track. This is track number 10. This 10? Is track number 10.
Okay.
And this is one of the huge, gigantic singles off of this album. It had a dope video to it.
Hmm.
Maybe we'll react to the video for our patrons. Also, speaking of our patrons, thank you to all our patrons that are pledging and supporting us on Patreon. We really appreciate your support.
Definitely.
Big thumbs up to you guys. And if you like our content and want to see uncut reactions, as well as us reacting to music videos and singles and stuff like that, then go ahead and consider pledging on Patreon. The link is in the bio of our YouTube channel. And yeah, check that out. But anyway... Yeah, we'll go ahead and roll into track number 10, Without Me. I like this joint.
You like this one?
I like this joint.
Okay.
It's a really big song. I feel like, I don't know, you never even heard Stronger, and that tripped me out off of Kanye's album. I'm like, everybody's heard that song.
No, I didn't.
That's all right. Okay, so this is Without Me.
All right.
Eminem, here we go.
Obie Trice. Two trailer park girls go round the outside, round the outside, round the outside. Two trailer park girls go round the outside, round the outside.
I like that.
Guess who's back? Back again. Shady's back. Tell a friend. Guess who's back? Guess who's back? Guess who's back? Well, if you want Shady, this is what I'll give you. A little bit of weed mixed with some hard liquor. Some vodka that'll jumpstart my heart quicker than a shock. When I get shocked at the hospital by the doctor. When I'm not cooperating. When I'm rocking the table while he's operating.
Yeah.
You waited this long to stop debating. Cause I'm back, I'm on the rag and ovulating. I know that you got a job, Miss Cheney. But your husband's heart problem's complicated. Out of all my lawsuits, fuck you, Debbie. Now this is a good job for me. So everybody, just follow.
Be talking smack.
Yeah. Just follow me, cause we need a little contract. I got everyone kissing my ass, and it's a disaster. Such a catastrophe for you to see. You ask for me, well, I'm back. Under your skin like a splinter, the center of attention, back for the winner. I'm interesting, the best things in wrestling, investing in your kids' ears and nesting. Let's kick worse than them little Limp Bizkit bastards. Obie, you could get stomped by Obie.
Damn.
36-year-old boy, that fat glow me. You don't know me, you're too old, let go, it's over. Nobody listen to techno, now let's go. Just give me the signal, I'll be there with a whole list full of new insults. I've been to
suspenseful with a pencil ever since Prince turned himself into a symbol. But sometimes the shit just seems everybody only wants to disgust me. So this must mean I'm disgusting. But it's just me, I'm just obscene. Yeah. Though I'm not the first kid of controversy. I am the worst things until this
press tight, man.
Black music so selfishly and use it to get myself wealthy.
Yeah.
Hey, there's a concept that works. 20 million other white rappers emerge. But no matter how many fish in the sea, it'll be so empty without me. Now this looks like a joke for me. So everybody just follow me. Cause yeah. We need a little controversy. Cause it feels so empty without me.
Rap, boy.
This looks like a job for me. So
rap.
Just
yeah.
Follow me. Cause we need a little controversy. Cause it feels so empty without me.
That even sounds good. And now they doing la 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 la. Yeah.
All right, that is the lead single off this album, Without Me. What'd you think about that one, Dad?
Nice hook. Nice beat. Nice music. Nice special effects, all of that, man. Mm-hmm. That was a good song. I liked it, just like I liked all the other ones before that one, man.
Yeah,
it's everything's been all good.
Cool. Yeah, that was a really, really popular song. It was accompanied with a really funny video.
Is that one of those songs that I probably should have heard?
One was really, really big song. I feel like you might even still hear this today, like some places, but. Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is a big song off of this album. He just absolutely like just killed these verses. It's a really catchy hook.
Mm-hmm.
It was a fun song. I enjoyed this quite a bit at this moment. So,
wow. And this was an amazing album. I mean, this album right here, just, you know, he could retire for the rest of his life on this one, man.
Yeah, he probably should have. Just kidding. Just kidding.
You're doing it to yourself now. You're doing it to yourself.
Just kidding, guys. I love Eminem. All right, we'll go ahead and next song.
All right, what's the next
one? The next one is track number 11. We've reached the halfway point in the album. This is Paul Rosenberg skit.
Uh-oh.
Paul is his record executive.
Mm-hmm.
So we've kind of heard them do this type of skit before where they kind of beef about what type of content that he's putting out and the record label saying that they can't sell it and stuff that. So he's kind of continuing with that.
All right.
So let's hear from Paul Rosenberg. And then, I'll stop and then go into sing for the moment.
All right.
Paul, listen. Joel just called me and he told me you're in the fucking back behind the studio shooting your gun off in the air like it's a shooting range. I told you not to fucking bring your gun around like an idiot outside of your home. You're going to get yourself in trouble. Don't bring your gun outside of your home. You can't carry it on you. Leave your fucking gun at home.
All right. So, yeah, I think that's a common theme throughout this album. He's, addressing his gun issues. So Paul's telling him to stop bringing his gun.
These are true stories.
I feel like, yeah.
True stories, man. I met you.
For sure. So then the next song here is Sing for the Moment. This is produced by Eminem. No feature on here. It does have a sample. I think it's an Aerosmith sample.
Oh, okay.
I might be wrong. They'll correct me if I am. Anyway, Sing for the Moment, Eminem, track number 12. Here we go.
Yeah. I don't know if it's Aerosmith, but I recognize
the sample, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. That's nice. That's a nice intro.
Mm-hmm.
These ideas are nightmares to white parents whose worst fear is a child with dyed hair and who likes earrings. Like whatever they say has no bearing. It's so scary in a house that allows no swearing. You see him walking around, broken home. There's no control. He just lets his emotions go.
Shame, shame, shame.
changing, intertwining with gangsters. In the land of the killers, a sinner's mind is a sanctum. To look like a loose cannon. In yep. dispute, won't hesitate to produce handguns. That's why these prosecutors wanna convict me. Strictly just to get me off of these streets quickly. But all they kids be listening to me religiously.
Right, that's
so
right.
I'm signing CDs while police fingerprint me. They're for the judge's daughter, but it's grudges against me. If I'm such a fucking menace, this shit doesn't make sense, B. It's all political. If my music is literal and I'm a criminal, how the fuck can I raise a little girl? I couldn't, I wouldn't wow. be to. You're full of shit too, Guerrero. That was a bitch that hit
Whoa.
You.
Calling them out too, don't
Sales, you ignoramus. Music is reflection of self. We just explain it, and then we get our checks in the mail. Let's start to paint it. How we can come from practically nothing to being able to have any fucking thing that we wanted. That's why we sing for these kids who don't have a thing except for a dream and a fucking rat magazine.
Whoa. Whoa. Sound good,
yeah.
Yeah.
All right, so that is track number 11, or I'm sorry, 12. Man,
that last
show.
Little part, he just could have kept that going a little bit longer right there, man.
The guitar
that
solo,
oh,
yeah.
Man, yeah. That was nice. That was a real good song.
You like that one?
Yeah, I
like
that. That was a real good song.
Yeah, he definitely just breaking down, you know, his beef with the industry, his beef with, like, people that criticize him and stuff. I think that's kind of, like, his ongoing theme. Aerosmith sample's cool.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. All right, cool.
What'd you think about it?
That was one I used to skip.
That's why I asked you that. I figured that was one of you to skip. I wanted you to say it.
To skip, yeah. And that was actually a really popular song. That was one of the singles off of that. It had a music video and everything. Yeah, I just...
Then you weren't feeling it.
Yeah, it's cool.
Not your type of song.
Not my jam.
That jam was rocking.
All right.
Let's see what the next one is.
Cool. I like this song right here. Superman was another single off of here. And... this one, he's going at Kim a little bit as well.
Superman
featuring Dina Ray, and she is the singer that was on the last album, on the last Eminem album as well. So okay. I like her voice. I think you enjoyed it too on the last album. Yeah. This one is produced by Eminem. Here we go, Superman.
I know you want me, baby. I think I want you too.
I think I love you, baby.
I think I love you too. I'm here to save you, girl. Come be in Shady's world. I wanna grow together. Let's let our love unfurl. You know you want me, baby. You know I want you too.
Uh-oh.
They call me Superman. I'm here to rescue you. I wanna save you, girl. Come be in Shady's world. Bitch, you make
they
me
call
girl.
Me Superman. Beat tall hoes in a single bound. I'm single now. Got no ring on his finger now. I never let another chick bring me down in a relationship. Save it, bitch. Babysit. You make me sick. Superman ain't saving shit. Girl, you can jump on Shady's dick. Straight from the hip. Cut to the chase. I tell a motherfucking slut to her face. Play no games. Say no names. Ever since I broke up with what's a fit. What you trying to be my new wife? What you Mariah? Fly through twice. But I do know one thing, no. Bitches, they come, they go. Saturday through Sunday, Monday. Monday through Sunday, yo. Maybe I'll love you one day. Maybe we'll someday grow. Till then, just sit your drunk ass on that fucking runway, ho. But females lie, but I guess that's just what sluts do. How could it ever be just us two? I never loved you enough to trust you. We just met and I just fucked you. But I do know one thing, no. Bitches, they come, they go. No Marshall at all, so don't grow partial. That's ammo for my arsenal. I slap you off that bar stool. There goes another lawsuit. Leave handprints all across you. Good loaded, loaded. You must be going off that water bottle.
Oh,
you
God.
Want what you can't have. Ooh, girl, that's too damn bad. Don't touch what you can't grab. End up with two back hands.
Ooh.
Put anthrax on a Tampax and slap you till you can't stand.
Damn.
Girl, you just blew your...
All right, that is track number 13, Superman, featuring Dina Ray. What'd you think about that one, Dad?
Another good song.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm feeling this whole album, man. I don't see anything. I see why people wanted to hear it.
Yeah.
You know, I definitely can see that. Yeah, Superman, that was a good song. Nice music, man. I mean, when you think of Eminem, you don't think of the production like on that last song,
mm-hmm.
that it was so musical. And a lot of his songs are musical like that.
Yeah.
And I'm just like, when I think Eminem, I just don't think of him like being that musically creative. Mm-hmm. But just like these were produced, a lot of these songs were produced by him, right?
Yeah. Majority, so, I think most of it is produced by him.
And I'm impressed.
Well, if you think about it, Eminem was signed to Dr. Dre.
Right.
And he worked very closely with Dre,
mm-hmm.
You know, as he was, you know, ascending in his career.
Mm-hmm.
And previously, Dre had produced a lot of stuff, as well as his guy, Rob Bass, or is that his name? Whatever. But the Bass Brothers or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
And then I feel like, you know, him just being around that,
mm-hmm.
you know, at some point in time, he was like, oh, I got it from here.
You know what? You know, I see what you're saying. I understand that. And then I was looking at it from a different point of view. I think that being around that influence around that Dr. Dre had on him,
mm-hmm.
that was profound. I do believe that.
Mm-hmm.
But man, the way Eminem, the way when I look at his talent,
mm-hmm.
you know, you could be around Dr. J and don't know nothing. I mean, just never learn anything.
Yeah, just let him do it.
Yeah, mm-hmm. but. Eminem is so talented that I think he took from Dr. Dre, but at the same time, a lot of that is just all his natural talent, man. Mm-hmm. Eminem flows with just big talent.
Yeah.
That's where I see him, man. I used to look at him like a little crazy dude. You know, I've seen him on little videos here and there, and I'm like, that's a little crazy self. And then when you start digging deep like we doing now,
mm-hmm. Yeah,
this album, this one right here, I know what we listened to last week, but this one right here,
it's up there. You feeling this one?
Yeah, but you keep hitting me with this, and every time I listen to one album, then the next week it'll be like, oh man, this album is so good too. But you know, okay, but this one's really good. I like it so cool. far. So what with this one is number 13.
That was track number 13, Superman. Mm-hmm. And
Superman.
Yeah, okay. I will say that Superman, to me, I really love the production on that one. I like the content. You know, he's pretty much saying it. He ain't finna save no hoes. Loving that.
Yeah, yeah.
But yeah, I just think the Definitely. Production is a lot different than most of the other production on this album. It's a little less dark, I guess, and a little
okay.
more of a bounce to it. So
okay.
I just always really enjoyed the production and that on that song in particular.
All right, I'm glad you pointed it out because I didn't look at it that way. Less
dark.
Dark. Yeah.
Yeah.
So okay. So and you're right. You're right.
Yeah.
Now that we reflect back on it. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So all right.
Well, yeah. He loves you know, he loves the strings. He uses the strings to really make that kind of like Live. Somber sound, and like it's big and kind of epic. You know, mm-hmm. and he it's his own style, and I think that he does it super well, especially on this album.
So this one here is Haley's song?
Yes, the next track here
That's
is
daughter, right?
number 14, which is Haley's song. Yep, Haley is his daughter. This one's produced by Eminem.
Okay.
I always really like this song, too. It's
going to tug at your heart.
Oh, wait. No, this ain't the one I'm thinking.
It's not
I'm
the one.
Thinking of My Dad's Gone Crazy, and that's track number 19. This is Haley's song. So this is an ode to his daughter mm-hmm. after a tough battle with his baby mom. And finally, Eminem had got custody of her, and he was really happy about that. So, Haley song.
Okay.
Yo, I can't sing, but I feel like singing. I wanna fucking sing. Cause I'm happy. Yeah, I'm happy.
Bears at all.
Show, what'd you think about that one, Dad?
Nice. Like I said, he holds no bar, man. He just like he just bears his inner everything, man. He just, that's why I think a lot of why he's, you know, so popular, man. He just tells his how he feels on the inside, deep personal stuff,
mm-hmm.
and then people can kind of like, oh, I felt that way too,
mm-hmm.
you know. So that was a good song.
Yeah.
What'd you think about the song though? You skipped that one?
I used to skip that one. but I will say, giving it this listen right now, I think that is an incredibly heartfelt song.
Mm-hmm.
And just for that to be such a real moment in his life at that time, you know, gaining custody of his daughter, I just can't imagine how, you know, happy he must have felt in that moment.
Yeah, he sang a lot.
Yeah. I bet. And just that victory and that feeling to be reunited with his daughter and stuff, like, super dope.
What'd you think about the music, though, in that song?
I think it was very fitting for the for the song. And I think, especially in that third verse where it's kind of swelling up and the string section is,
you know,
building and stuff behind him rapping, because he sings the first two verses and then he raps the third verse completely. And I thought that was a great way to like bring it home. And yeah, hey, the song's cool.
Ah,
mm-hmm.
You listen well, Grasshopper.
Still not bumping it.
Why not? That does not surprise me. I should have known that was coming.
Oh, man. Sorry, guys. All right, we'll go ahead and get to...
Well, I'm ready to hear some more. Because I haven't heard a bad cut on this thing.
Yeah. It's not bad. Like, anyway, The Steve Berman skit.
Okay.
Steve Berman, I can't remember, he's a manager or one of the record people or something. He was telling Eminem he couldn't put the album out on the last album.
Uh-huh.
So this is Steve Berman again.
All
right. Here we go.
It's ridiculous. I can't believe it. Hold on a minute. Em,
what up?
Have a seat. Dre, I'll call you back.
What now?
I don't even know where to start.
Okay.
I got the album from upstairs.
And
this is by far the most
incredible thing I've ever heard.
All right. Steve Irwin skit. What do you think about that one?
So he's trigger happy, huh? He didn't even let him. He thought he was going to give him bad news. He was giving him good news.
Exactly.
Damn. Oops.
Oops. All right. We'll go ahead and roll into the next track, which is titled When the Music Stops, featuring D12. That's Eminem's group from Detroit, The Dirty Dozen, produced by D-Non and Eminem. Here is When the Music Stops.
All right. Music. Reality. Sometimes it's hard to tell the difference. But we as entertainers have a responsibility to these kids.
If I were to die murdered in cold blood tomorrow, would you feel sorry, show love, or would it matter? Could never be the leader or batter if things shit for me to feed off. I'm seesaw battling, but there's way too much at stake for me to be fake. There's too much on my plate. I done came way too far in this game to turn and walk away and not say what I got to say. What the fuck you take me for? A joke? You smoking crack? Before I do that, I beg Mariah to take me back. I get up before I get down. Run myself in the ground before I put some wax shit out. I'm trying to smack this one out the park. 5,000 mark. Y'all steady trying to drown the shark. Ain't gonna do nothing but piss me off. Lid to the can of whip ass. Just twist me off. See me leap out. Pull a piece out. Fuck shooting. I'm just trying to knock his teeth out. Fuck with me now, bitch, to see you freestyle. Talk is cheap. Motherfucker, if you really feeling frog asleep. Yo, Slim, you gon' let him get away with that? He try to play you. You can't let him skate with that. Man, I hate this crap. This ain't rap. This is crazy the way we act. When we confuse hip-hop with real life. When the music stops.
No getting rid of it, babe. If so, you wanna try. The only way I'm leaving this bitch is suicide. I have died clinically. I ride back at my enemy's crib with Hennessy. Got drunk, then I finished it. Before we spark, hug the floor while we playing tug of war with your life. Fuck a tour on the mic. I'd rather fuck a whore with a knife. Deliver that shit that coroners like. You hype popping shit in broad daylight. Nigga, you are gonna realize it stops.
Instigators turn pits in cages. Let loose and bit the neighbors. List the razors. Y'all don't want war. Y'all want talk. In the dark, my dogs all bark like hoof. Hoof, nigga, I'm a wolf. Get your own roof. Caved in like reindeer hoofs. Stomp the roof, shake the floor tiles loose. The more y'all breach, the more I lose. It's Hill Street, this is hardcore blues. Put a gun to rap, checking all our dudes. Or make the news, bet your all y'all move. When the Uzi pop, you better drop when the music stops.
Music has changed my life in so many ways. Brains confused and fucked since the fifth grade.
Boys are tight, man.
NWA said fuck the police. Now I'm in jail. 93 was strictly R&B. Shock. I'm reaching for the clock, but the music stops.
All right. That is When the Music Stops featuring D12. What'd you think about that one?
I love D12, man. Those guys, man, they were all tight. They were, I mean, all of them had it. You could tell that they had their own style. Some of them, I can't remember which one it was. He seemed like he still had some to be polished a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
But the rest of them were like.
Was it the last one?
No, it was more like, I think it was the second or third one.
Okay.
Yeah. So anyway, but D12, man.
It was dope.
They were entertaining.
Yeah.
It was good. And I just like the musical, like, you know, all the love. That piano constantly was dun, dun. And then every now and then, when you got right near the end of a chorus, the violins go da 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 or something like that. And so I was like, yeah. It's like I don't know. I like little stuff like that.
Yeah,
that's
for
what
sure.
makes me like music. So, yeah.
Cool. All right. So that was When the Music Stops. We'll go ahead and move right into track number 17. This is called "Say What You Say," featuring Dr. Dre, produced by Dr. Dre.
Okay.
All right, so
it's gonna sound West Coast to me, and I bet you.
Yeah, well, we'll see. Say what you say. Here we go.
So I'm out the game, huh? Yo, Dre,
we riding.
Whatever.
Well, I'm with you, homie.
Okay. Let's handle the small shit.
I was born to brew up storms, stir up shit, kick up dust, cost till I slur up spit, grew up
too quick, went through too much, knew too much shit. Corrupt, and I'ma pour it on like syrup, bitch. Thick and rich, sick and twisted, Mr. Buttersworth. Dre told me to milk this shit for what it's worth. To the cop just tilts and tips and stumbles the earth. And if I fumble the verse, keep
vote. When I see you, I'ma step on you and not even know it. You midget, mini me.
Talking about Jermaine Dupri.
Bunch of little mini yours running around your backyard, swimming pools.
Damn.
Over 80 million records sold. And I ain't have to do it with 10 or 11 year olds. Cause what you say is what you say. Say what you say.
Jermaine Dupri produced Lil Bow Wow.
Just remember how you said it when you were spraying it. So who you playing with, huh? Cause what you say is what you say. Say what you say. Another punch on punk rock. No one's punk. Don't give a fuck. White pop. So much punk. When I was little, I knew I would blow up and sell a miller. Grow up to be a tiller. Go nuts and be a killer.
And I'm something of a phenom. One puff of the crown. I'm unstoppable. I'm alive and on top again. There's no obstacle that I can't conquer. So come along with us.
Come on. Cause what you say is what you say. Say what you say. How you say it whenever you saying it. Just remember how you said it when you were spraying it. So who you playing with, huh?
But I handle my business cause it's work before play.
Don't get hard, man.
Serve you gourmet. However you want it, you can have it your way.
This
fuck my night up, I'ma fuck up your day.
Yeah.
Pull it with your name, sending it your way. That goes for anyone who walks through that doorway. Cause this is my space.
Hey, invaded, yeah.
Live to invade it. Die trying to violate it. Fuck around, get annihilated. Eyes dilated.
Like my old lady. Cause what you say is what you say. Sometimes what you mean is two different things. Depending on your mood, it swings.
I heard that.
Too many things. Little hit of Dre's weed, I can do anything. Catch a contact and a
watch your fucking mouth.
Yo, this Timbaland. Tell him I said suck. Look at my day.
All right, that is Say What You Say.
Is it my dear?
Say what you say. Track number 17 on the Eminem Show. What'd you think about that one, Dad?
Oh, that was a good song, man. I enjoyed that song, man. Now, to me, they was hitting it hard, and to me, they blended so well on that song together.
Mm-hmm, back and
it
forth.
It was like, yeah, they was just like flowing with one another. They was like two rappers in one. I mean, man, that was a good song to me.
Yeah,
you skipped that one.
That's definitely on, one of them man. I used to
say
skip.
What you say, man, come on.
I just always
man.
Felt like that song just like dragged, like it just was like a I don't know, I just never really liked that one. And I always thought like the producer beef was kind of whack. Like I don't know. I think somebody asked Jermaine a question in an interview, and then he kind of was bigging himself up and kind of dissing Timberland and Dr. Dre or whatever.
Well, it was getting out of hand by then. It was getting stupid. I get it.
Yeah.
I get it. It
I was just always stupid thought that then, was kind of whack. Like, producer beef. Like, that's...
I see what you're saying, though.
I don't know.
He had to have something going on,
yeah,
you know?
Sure. He wanted to shoot back at Jermaine Dupri, and that's cool. And
you know, but that wasn't an even fight either. You know what I mean?
Oh yeah, yeah, that's not even at all. You go get Eminem, and who got Jermaine Dupri got Lil Bow Wow? Like, come on, man.
No, that wasn't
not
an
fair.
Even fight at all, man. That's not even close. Like, poor Jermaine.
Yeah,
man.
Poor Jermaine. Yeah, I don't know. That was never one of my favorites off of there either.
Well, it was just being big bullies, man. Maybe that's why you didn't like it. It was just being
big
ass bullies.
Yeah. All right, cool. We'll go ahead and roll it to track number 18. This is titled Till I Collapse. This is featuring one of your favorites, Nate Dogg.
Uh-oh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And
like
this one is produced by Eminem.
All right.
And so, yeah, I like this one.
You like that one?
I like this one.
Okay. Then I know the ones you like, I always like. So
yeah.
I know I'm going to like it.
Till I Collapse featuring Nate Dogg.
All right.
Sometimes you just feel tired, feel weak. And when you feel weak,
this song always makes it into my workout playlist.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. It's like one of them.
find your inner strength.
It is motivational in the beginning. I know that.
So I collapse. I'm spilling these raps long as you feel them. To the day that I drop, you'll never say that I'm not killing them. Cause when I am not, then I'm gonna stop pinning them. And I am not hip hop, and I'm just not Eminem. Subliminal thoughts when I'm gonna stop sending them. Women are caught in webs, spinning them in hawk venom. Adrenaline shots, the penicillin could not get the illness to stop. Amoxicillin's just not real enough.
Can't shut my mouth. Am I high?
I just like his voice, man. Like Ludacris. I like Ludacris' voice.
Music again, and when you run is over, just admit when it's in its
end. Love it. Love it.
I got a list. Here's the order of my list that it's in. It goes Richie, Jay-Z, Tupac, and Biggie. I'm right from Outkast, Jada, Corrupt, Nas, and Thimmy. But in this industry, I'm the cause of a lot of envy.
There
so
you
when
go.
I'm not put on this list, the shit does not offend me. That's why you see me walk around like nothing's bothering me. Even though
half
your people got a fucking problem with me. You hate it, but you know respect you got to give me. The press is wet dream like Bob and your Whitney. Nay, kick me.
Till the room comes off. Till my leg give out. Can't shut my mouth. Can't shut my mouth. Till the smoke clears out. And my eye.
Alright.
I'm gonna rip this shit.
Boy.
As soon as the verse starts, I eat it at MC's heart. Clever when I put together every word. My thoughts are sporadic. I act like I'm an addict. I rap like I'm addicted to smack like I'm in Mathis. But I don't wanna go for the constant battles. The fact is I would rather sit back and bomb some rappers. So this is like a full blown
Man, Bob was at a concert and I heard that song, boy, that would just be like,
Yeah, it's definitely some stadium concert music right there. All right.
Till I collapse.
Track number 18. What do you think about that one, Dad?
Man, like I said, I haven't heard one bad, but that one, like, and it keeps getting a little better song. So to me, no, I can't even say that, man, because the beginning songs were good too, man. This album is dope, man. I don't know what to
Hey, no, I feel you. It's a good album.
That was a good song, wasn't it?
I love that song. I think that song's super dope.
Was in there, man. He was just like, oh man, they was clowning.
I definitely always enjoyed that song. I always throw that like in my workout mix. That's like one of them ones. Like when it comes on, if I'm working out and it's like literally the best song to help you like push through, like finish. You know, it's like till I collapse. Like I'm not going. Yeah, yeah.
It's a good idea.
It's a really good
I like
one.
That. You know what? I made you incorporate that into my little workout routine.
Yeah, yeah. Just you
play
definitely
that song
should.
On there and just like, yeah, go for it. Then.
Yeah, yeah. You got to keep going hard when you hear that one. So, all
right.
Yeah.
My dad's gone crazy.
Track number 19.
Who's
on
dad don't go
Eminem, on Eminem show. This one's featuring Eminem's daughter, Haley Jade, produced by Dr. Dre. And get right into it. My dad's gone crazy.
Hello, boys and girls.
Did you relate to that?
Don't
let you answer that. Don't even answer.
Do you have a daddy?
I bet you do.
Who's your daddy?
Daddy, what are you doing? Okay, then! Everybody, listen up!
I'm going to hell! Who's coming with me?
He's going to hell!
Push this motherfucking button and blast off and launch one of these Russians and that's off. Blow every
music's good. No one got the sinister kind of feel to it.
It's like my mother always told me. Fuck that shit, bitch. Eat a motherfucking dick. Chew on a brick and lick a million motherfucking cocks per second. I'd rather put out a motherfucking gospel record. I'd rather be a pussy whip, bitch. Eat pussy and have pussy lips glued to my face with a clit ring in my nose. Then quit bringing my flows by his toes. Man, I don't know no more. Am I the only fucking one who's normal anymore?
He pissed off a lot of people there, man.
I can't explain it.
He don't care.
A little help from Haley
J. Violins, man, are cutting out.
No one on earth that can save me, not even Haley. My songs can make you cry, take you by surprise at the same time. Can make you dry your eyes with the same rhyme. So what you're seeing is the genius at work. Which to me isn't work, so it's easy to misinterpret it at first. Cause I'm dying, come
that's
back,
deep right there, what he just said.
And walk around the rest of my life spit on and kicked. Every time I sung, like R. Kelly, as soon as Bumping Grind comes on, more pain inside of my brain than the eyes of a little girl inside of a plane.
Wow.
Ain't the World Trade, standing on Ronnie's grave, screaming at the sky till clouds gather. It's Clyde Mathers and Bonnie J. Haley J, won't you tell them me?
Wow.
That little girl's
You're
voice.
Funny, Daddy.
That little girl's voice, man. That was tripping me out. But this was so musical.
Yeah, my dad's going crazy. What'd you think about that one?
Real, really, really musical. You can enjoy the music, but then he was rapping, man, and stuff he was saying again. I enjoyed that one as well.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was a good one.
My
dad's gone crazy.
I always really loved that song. I just think, just like you're mentioning, the instrumental on that is just really fun. And it's got the Dre bounce to it. I just thought that was really one of the beats that stuck out to me on this one. So I always came back to that record. Mm-hmm. And then, yeah, he just absolutely just kills those verses. And it's like, that to me is like when Eminem's at his best, when he's just saying all this crazy stuff and putting his words together real cool. And that's my favorite Eminem type of tracks. But I always really liked that one. I'll let the outro skit play and then we'll recap the album here.
Okay.
Close the curtains, closed.
It's the last one.
Mm-hmm.
This thing on.
All right, as curtains close, skit. I don't know if you remember Ken Kniff was the gay fictional character that Eminem made up on his last album that was getting a blowjob from the guys he was beefing with skit.
That's right.
So, yeah, Ken Kniff closing the curtains on the album. This is the conclusion of the Eminem show. What'd you think about the album, Dad?
Rub my back.
This album was so good, man. I think I counted out of the, it was 20 songs, right? I think I counted 4 skip overs that you used to do, right? Was it 4 or was it more? We're not going to dive into that. Yeah. All right, because you've done enough. Yeah. All right, so this album, it was fantastic. I like every single song. I like his creativity. He has such a colorful mind. I mean, it's just like he just articulates stuff in ways that you be like, damn. You know, it's just, I like, it's entertaining. The music was on point, man. And whatever influence Dre had on him, man, he must have been like a sponge.
Mm-hmm.
And he just soaked it all in, and then he made it Eminem.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So Great album. Great album. I enjoyed this one.
Awesome. So you enjoyed the songs and the lyrics and the beats, the production. Like I said, and as we saw, Eminem produced most of this album. A little bit of help from the Bass Brothers and Dr. Dre. But pretty much.
D12.
Yeah, we had the D12 features on there. Not a ton of features on here either. Just D12 was on that song. And then we had Dre on the other song. And Dina Ray was singing on the other song, and Dre or Nate Dogg,
Eminem. I mean, his footprint is just like it's all Eminem, pretty much.
Yeah,
I mean,
for sure.
You know, he had nice touches of people he brought in to collaborate with, but basically, this is all Eminem, man. And it's just it displays how talented he really is, man. And the guy, I mean, he's pretty much. I would probably have to say he is borderline genius, if not genius.
Oh yeah, for sure. Absolutely. I mean, you don't sell as many records as Eminem and have such a long career and go through all the, trials and tribulations as he has, and you know, without some type of, really, really high level of talent and genius. So
you know what? Here's the thing, and I don't want to lose my thought. Cut you off. But during this journey in the beginning, when we started exploring rap music and rappers and stuff like that,
mm-hmm.
It's amazing to me that the things that I'm learning about these guys.
Mm-hmm.
And the thing about it is that you just heard me say Eminem is a genius.
Mm-hmm.
But a lot of these rappers to me are geniuses. Like your Jay-Z's, mm-hmm. your Kanye's, your Kendrick Lamar's.
Mm-hmm.
Man,
yeah,
these guys, man, they have brilliant minds to produce this type of music.
Yeah.
And it's not... Is okay, put it like this. In the beginning, old school guy, rap is trash. I'm just going to put it out there. It's just trash.
That's what you thought before.
Yeah, I'm just, right. Rap music, I'll cut that shit off. Just turn it off, you know?
Yeah.
But now, man, I'm just like, sit down, I've consumed it.
Yeah.
And, dude, at least these albums, now I'm pretty sure there is some trash out there.
Oh, there's a lot. Know? There's plenty of trash. There's plenty of trash.
But I don't want to hear that.
Yeah.
But I probably need to hear it.
Yeah.
To get a well-rounded outlook on the whole rap thing.
Yeah. I think I'm not going to play like nothing just like stupid trash. Maybe like just to show you like maybe some videos or something, like some singles and stuff.
Right, right.
Probably not like a full like a full album.
Yeah, that wouldn't be fun.
Sit down review.
Yeah, yeah.
But then the thing is also like... just like this album right here, like you really enjoyed this album. I've heard this album before, even now, like it's just not my favorite album. You know, it's not something mm-hmm. I run to go listen to.
Mm-hmm.
But that's like the dope thing about rap is like, you know, somebody might like something more than another person,
right.
You know, and
everybody has their own taste.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Exactly. But I can definitely respect Eminem as an artist and his lyricism and his ability to produce records and put out some dope stuff. So cool. That's the Eminem show. You guys happy? Good. Because we're done.
They're not done with you.
Yeah, they're not done with me. Here's to the next month and a half of comments.
You think this is whack? You obviously don't understand.
I know.
That's what you
I
get.
Know. That's cool. We put it on the internet, so we gotta be open to people reacting to it.
That's the fun part about it to me.
For sure.
You know, it's funny. It's just like it just makes you laugh, you know. And if you can laugh about stuff that people say,
yeah,
you know.
I do be just cracking up and just having fun, just messing with people when I comment them back and stuff, being right. sarcastic. It's fun.
Yeah.
And it's like, and it's also, you know, you get to joke around, but then also there's some people that leave like some really heartfelt comments and some just really super nice things. Actually,
really nice.
I took a screenshot of a recent comment. Okay, Kathleen Sosa left us a comment on one of our videos, and she said, "This feels to this video. Wow, just want to."
want you to know the vibrations your videos bring to all your viewers is beyond words. Seeing Black Joy is one of the most beautiful things to witness, and watching your dad get giddy over slow jams had tears streaming down my face. Absolutely love your content and the positive portrayal you're eliciting through your bond of music and culture. Much love. So, yeah, I don't know. I just read that one. It just stuck out to me.
Yeah, that's really nice.
And, yeah, I wanted to share that with you and share it with our viewers.
Wow.
And give a big shout-out to Kathleen Sosa for dropping that comment.
Thank you, Kathleen.
We really appreciate that. But, yeah, that concludes the Eminem Show. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Please consider checking out our Patreon. And you'll get uncut reactions, you'll get single reactions, music video reactions, and whatever extra content we might throw on there. You also get to chat with us on Discord and join the Discord server that Jace runs, and he's killing it at that. And if you guys have any suggestions, please DM Jace on Discord and let him know what you guys want to see on Discord. Yeah, we our Discord server, Jace is the... He's the admin there.
Oh, okay, so cool, cool.
He's handling that.
My little man.
Yeah. I'll have to get you in the Discord so you can chat with some of the subscribers and stuff.
I'd like to.
Yeah, and then also, please give this video a big thumbs up. Drop a comment what album we should review next. Probably not going to be an Eminem album. And also... turn on your post notifications so you're notified every time that we drop a new video. Thank you so much, you guys.
We didn't get tequila today either.
Oh, no tequila. That's a fact. What? We drank all the tequila.
Yes.
Well you drank
that
all
was
the
last
tequila.
Week.
Okay. I mean, all right. Well, make sure you subscribe to our Patreon so I can buy my dad some tequila. Appreciate you guys. Gap Gang. We'll see you next time. Bye.
Bye.